I don't know what to do.
Hey, RJ. What's up? In all my 50 years at this hospital, I've never seen you this down bad.
I'm just really worked up. All my patients are still sick. No matter what I do, I'll never be as great as you. These scrubs barely even fit. I don't even know who I am anymore. I can't do my job right.
Hey, slow down. Let's talk this through.
Okay, fine. So these are my patients. I have Feline Career, who can't get herself off the ground. I have Beau DiMaggio, who has a whole list of problems. It's unbelievable. And I have Jane Doe. Jane Doe doesn't even know who she is.
Have you ever consulted the Great Textbook?
The Great Textbook. I mean, I know it's taught at like every medical school across the country, and it's been like that for a long time, but I never understand it. I can't read it by myself. And I feel like whoever wrote this Great Textbook doesn't get me or my situation.
Well, I don't know if you knew this, but I actually wrote the Great Textbook 20 years ago.
What?
All right, so how about we go see your clients? And
okay, let's do it, let's go. But I'll only do it with your help.
All right.
Hello, Ms. Veer. I'm here with my colleague, Dr. Godfrey, and we're going to try and help you the best we can. Why don't you tell him about the issues you're facing?
Everything seems fine. It's just I can't seem to get off the ground. Every day I try getting up, but I just keep on falling over and over again.
Why don't you show Dr. Godfrey what exactly you mean?
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
I'm okay with the crutches, but
yeah, happens every time, every single time. See what I mean?
No.
Here, let me help you. Just take a seat. See what I mean? I've never encountered anything like this in my medical career. I've run a billion tests, but none of them come up positive.
I see. What if I told you that it was possible for you, Felinka, to not only stand, but to also walk?
I hope that was true.
Do you not know? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He will not grow tired or weary of his, and his understanding no one can fathom. No, he gives strength to the weary and increases the power of the weak. Even youths grow tired and weary, and young men stumble and fall. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. Come on, Felinka. I know you can make it. You can get up again. You just need to put confidence in the systems God put in place for you in your body and keep trying. Every time you fall, get up.
Okay, I'll try.
Doing it.
I'm standing.
She's standing.
I'm standing.
How did you do that? Okay, so we figured out Feline Career, but this one is a real doozy, Doc. Meet Beau DiMaggio. Mr. Beau, why don't you give Dr. G the rundown?
I'd be glad to, Doc. You might want to take a seat. I have a cough that is like worse than the room 45, and my abdominal pain, like, it hurts so much more than room 27. I also like I think I broke my leg yesterday when I went on a walk, and it's just horrible. I just can't seem. Oh my goodness, I forgot.
Didn't you say that you had something like patient in room 23? Who was it again? Laurentius?
Yeah, whatever that thing is.
Okay.
And it's definitely worse than him, by the way.
I see. I have a question for you. What would you happen to have similar to patient 87?
We should probably go check it out.
There is no patient 87. But pull yourself together. When did you feel your first symptom?
As soon as I walk into this hospital.
Wait a minute.
You seem to be struggling with something very common. Bo, you've forgotten who you are and where you belong. Worst of all, you're looking at the outsides of other people to tell you about what's inside your body. This comparison to others is what's making you sick. There's so much good and beautiful about your body, and it was fearfully and wonderfully made. Stop putting demands on it.
I am free. I'm handsome.
All right. What do you know about patient number 3? They say her name is Jane Doe.
I know nothing.
Come on, let's not exaggerate. What's wrong, ma'am?
No, for real. I know nothing. What do you know?
I don't know.
She can't remember anything. She has amnesia.
What's amnesia?
We need to figure this out. She has a job somewhere, a family somewhere. She doesn't even know where the phone is. How can we let her out of the hospital like this?
All right. God's got it. Does your head hurt?
Nope.
Does your back hurt?
Nope.
Does your brain hurt?
Nope.
I see. I think this may be something the great book calls an identity crisis. You've forgotten who you are and where you belong. And now, because you've forgotten those things, you are lost. I wrote in the great book, before I formed you, I knew you. Before you were born, I set you apart. I appointed you as a prophet to the nations.
Wait a minute. I know who I am. I know where I am. I'm with Alicia. Wait. I have class in 15 minutes. Oh my goodness. Get me out of here.
I guess she's healed? Wow, what a day. I would have never believed those things could even happen without your help and without the great textbook.
Audrey, wake up. Let's stop this madness.
What do you mean?
These weren't your patients. I don't even work in a hospital. Well, not like that.
Wait, what? Where are we? Is this Atlanta General?
No, this is Audrey General. All the patients we treated today were areas where you were struggling with self-love in your life. Failing career, body image, and Jane Doe. That's about your identity. Audrey, today has been about taking care of yourself. Wake up.
What's happening? Whoa.